people of this world, they live in sins because they are without God. Because without God, they are helpless before the devil and his army of demons. This life is like a raging sea, storming sea, which tries to make you drown. And if you're without God, you're helpless, you're gonna drown. Jesus Christ overcame this world. He is like a tall mountain. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but through him. And he is the strong rock who overcame the world. He is the strongest name in the whole universe. And if you follow Jesus Christ, then you must abide in him. You must seek him every day. And you do it through two major principles. You seek him through humility and through calling out to his name. Adam and Eve, they fell away from God because of pride. They got proud and they fell away from God. Now the way up, back to the Father, is through humility. The way of Jesus Christ is the way of humility. Jesus said, "Watch and pray, lest ye enter into temptation." Why did Jesus say to watch? To watch after yourself, after your heart. Because if your heart is prideful, there is no room for Holy Spirit in it. There is no brokenness. Holy Spirit comes to the broken heart. Holy Spirit comes to the poor in spirit. And if they really seek him like that, they will find him and he will come to them and they must overcome. Because if you're not overcoming sin, you're on the way to hell. You're a slave of sin. You must overcome sin. You must wage war against Satan. You must abide on that rock of Jesus Christ, that mighty mountain which no army of hell can overcome. And to ascend on that mountain, you have to humble yourself down and you have to call out for Jesus' name. And he will come and help you to ascend on that mountain. This life is made in such a way that if you're following Jesus Christ, if your destination is the kingdom of heaven because you're overcoming sin and you're obeying Jesus, then Satan will try to overcome you and you will drink this bitter cup. He will send sufferings your way. He will send afflictions. And the only way to overcome all that is to dissolve this bitter cup with the sweetness of Jesus Christ, with the sweetness of the living waters which come from Jesus. And Jesus himself showed us the example of denying himself. In the garden, before the crucifixion, Jesus prayed for several hours. He was praying and his sweat was mixed with blood. And he was saying in the end, "Father, thy will be done." Jesus denied himself and decided to go on that cross. And in that garden, he overcame. Then it manifested in the physical. He was crucified on the cross and he was victorious and he rose again from the dead and he overcame Satan. Same for us. If we want to follow Jesus Christ, we have to overcome. And to overcome, we have to abide in him. And to abide in him, we have to seek him in humility, in brokenness. And the higher the storms are, the more God motivates us to go lower in humility and to seek him more. Because it's not just enough to pray. If you pray but you don't have humility or you lack in humility, that means you don't have room for Holy Spirit or you lack room for Holy Spirit. Because the more you humble yourself down, the more Holy Spirit will come and live in you. Are you following Jesus today? Are you getting directions from him every day because he can speak what you must be doing and doing that to please him? You're not pleasing other people and their opinions. You're pleasing Jesus Christ. You're getting from him what you must be doing and you're doing exactly what he tells you to do. Or it's not so in your life. Are you serving your master or you're serving Satan and sin and world and you're on the way to hell? What about you today? If you die today, where will you go? What will Jesus tell you if you meet him today? If you meet him face to face and he will tell you, "Go away from me, I don't know you, you weren't following me, I don't know you, didn't get instructions from me, you weren't overcoming sin, you were serving self and sin and Satan and you're going to hell." Do you know Jesus? Does Jesus know you? Is Jesus Christ pleased with you today? Unfortunately, many Christians today are deceived by Satan. They're sinners and they're full of pride and they're on the way to hell as rockets. Wake up now. It's serious. Situation is very bad. Wake up before it's too late. Wake up. You're on the way to hell.